Well, beer is my main focus in life, I guess, next to my girlfriend and my son. Every day I think about beer, I drink beer, I taste beer and I brew beer. So it's a very big part of my life. Sander was 16, my brother. He got a brew pack for his birthday. Back then, you were legal to drink at 16 in Holland. I was a 14-year-old kid, and it was just a bag with malt extracts in it. And you needed to add water and yeast, and several weeks later, you would have beer. So this is where it really, really started. Sander's girlfriend initiated for his 30th birthday kind of a crowdfunding campaign amongst our friends, family, colleagues, etc. And that way we sold the first amounts of Van der Streek beer, and on Sander's birthday we gave him as a gift pack, well, the stack of orders and a bank account with the money on it to start brewing commercially ourselves. Van der Streek is our last name. We actually write it in one piece, as normally we would have three different words. And believe it or not, this means from the area, local, it means in Dutch. We have a core range of six different beers. 2018 we'll be adding a seventh beer to that. All of our beers are, I would say, very drinkable, made to drink. So in our core range we don't find any 12% stouts or crazy stuff like that. We do make them, those are one-offs and specials. In the back we have a little start for a barrel room, where we age our beers in whiskey, wine, port and whatever we can find, barrels. And then next to that we also do our creative series. Last year this has been the playground series, because this is our playground, this is where we come to play. And in the series we do everything for the first time, so use of new hops, new ways of packing our beer. Our first barrel-aged beer came out in that line, and also our first non-alcoholic IPA came out. All of our beers are focused on taste and flavors, not so much on the alcohol. I called a retailer, a bottle shop, I called the wholesaler here locally. I told them, you know, I really want to make a non-alcoholic IPA. And they were like, yeah, it might work, I'm not really sure. And so I decided we have three options for brew size. It's 20 hecto, 40 hecto, or 80 hecto. And I said, yeah, let's go for the middle then, you know, the middle road, like the Dutch always do. So let's do the 40 hecto. And we actually sold out within the first week. So we took a second batch, which was 80 hecto, that was sold out in a day. And yeah, next batch is actually coming 2 months from now. And then from there, once all the equipment is here from China, we'll be able to produce more and make a monthly batch of it. Our main beer is Broeders, which is the Dutch word for brothers. Of course, named after Sander and myself. It's a wheat blonde, if you translate it. But it's not a beer style at all. It's American yeast. It's half wheat, it's half barley, and it's with only German hops. It's brewed rather bitter, but still it's our main beer here. There's actually a few places who have this on draft the whole year round, and sell it as their main blonde beer instead of some of the Belgian blonde beers. Oh, I'm damn proud. I mean, if you look around here, in a real proper brewery, as I would like to say, I would have never guessed that this would be our brewery if you would have asked me like 2 or 3 years ago. And compared to my former job, I get up in the morning very early, very easily. I drive here with a big grin on my face. And when I leave, I still have that same grin on my face. So, and that's simply because of what we are accomplishing here every day.